Joe Staley threw John Lynch under the bus with Defoe, quote, Lynch is gone. Jimmy not an NFL caliber athlete. Was he throwing Lynch under the bus?
I thought he did a little bit. But yeah. I do want to say something about Joe Staley. I think he's also not as good in the media as he's given credit for. He's buddy-buddy with Kyle Shanahan, and he protects the hell out of Kyle Shanahan. Ripping on Jimmy Garoppolo yesterday was like, it was, I thought it was the soft option. Jimmy Garoppolo doesn't start himself. If I think more or less everybody's been aware of what Jimmy Garoppolo was. Like, were you shocked that he played like that on Sunday Night Football against the solid
defense? No, I was just surprised that Joe was so candid about his former teammate.
Yeah, you know what he should have been candid about? The fact that his coach is stuck by this former teammate rather than, you know, not making his decision. But they got to go 4th of July and throw some more footballs across houses to pizza ovens. So,
yeah, they got plans for the offseason. Anthony says, why should anyone trust Jimmy? He's the used car salesman of quarterbacks. You think you have a winner and it falls apart. I'd rather trust a squirrel with my nuts. Thank you, Anthony. That was...
well said,
poetic. Okay, Brandon says, what are your thoughts on a BFF reunion with Chris Sims coming in as a GM if they fire Lynch? No, nothing against Chris Sims, but can we get like an experienced personnel guy from a good, or can we just do it the old-fashioned way? Just the old-fashioned way.
GMs, there's a lot that goes into being a GM that just watching film and evaluating talent. Like, that's the mistake the Raiders made with Mayock. Mayock took Quill and Ferrell at 4. That's Mayock is pretty good at evaluating talent in the draft. I mean, he's as good as anybody else. He has a passion for it. He was good at it on TV. But being a GM, you have to manage the cap. You have to manage who you re-sign, who you sign. You have to manage a culture. You have to create an organization. There's so much that goes into it.
James, thank you. Michael says, Jimmy threw more tight spirals with the gloves on.
Do you think so? I saw that wobbler to Charlie Warner house. Oof.
The miss to Dwelly. It's simple. Lamar Jackson was talked about bad for his accuracy. Trey's probably more accurate in year one. So would you not take Lamar today?
He's not more accurate than Lamar Jackson year one, in my opinion. But I of course I'd take Lamar today. And that's what we're saying about Trey Lance. We're saying just wait on it. Let him play. Yeah. Let's go through it.
I'm excited. I know Niner fans are down, but I'm not a Niner fan. I'm excited for the next part of the season. I've been looking forward to the Trey Lance era for a long time. I think it's going to be really interesting. I don't think it's going to be an instant success, but I think it's going to be extremely interesting, and I'm looking forward to it. Did you catch when Shanahan implied a conspiracy about all headsets going out at the same time? That was a little weird. Dude is off his rocker. Dude, it's a home game.
Yeah.
You're at Levi's. What are you talking about?
You should have been watching the game. He's just lucky that he's Kyle Shanahan, honestly. That was backwards pass, butt fumble bad.
Yeah.
If Matt Patricia did that, you know how bad that was? That was Chuck Pagano calling that weird ass punt fake with two offensive linemen and a punter, and the punter just getting walloped after snapping the ball. That's how bad that was.
Reggie McKenzie for GM put the foundation for the Raiders together until the other guy came along. Thoughts? I always liked Reggie, but I mean he's had some huge misses. I don't know.
Carl Joseph. I'm not sure.
Who? Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. They're
Carl Joseph.
I would look at like guys who have had success within the last 5 years at successful organizations. That's where I would start. Saints, Chiefs, Patriots.
Saints. There's a guy named Jeff Ireland. He was Parcells' guy. Since they brought Jeff Ireland to the Saints, my dad, I'll give him credit. He was the one who pointed it out to me. The Saints transform of drafting culture started in 2017 when they hired Jeff Ireland. And since then, they've been one of the best teams at drafting in football. That's who I
think. About Jeff Ireland? I'm good with that. Yeah, someone who's had some success in the current NFL. MD2020 says, Kyle's like a little spoiled little kid that got everything in life. Now, as an adult, he's finally facing real adversity like the rest of us simpletons.
I don't know his life.
I mean, man, he's been an OC for a long time in the NFL, and he hasn't had a lot of success. It's just I think people have just kind of projected a lot of things onto him that aren't necessarily there because they know his dad and they know his name. We'll get back on track at Chicago. 10 wins and a wild card. Kyle needs to get out of his days.
You gotta go watch that.
Ten wins. They have to go 8-3 the rest of the way, dude.
Yeah. And that Chicago Bears front, hey, also the weather. The weather in Chicago has not been great. It's really windy right now. Jimmy Garoppolo is going to – I mean, do you remember the game last year? The New Orleans Saints, Drew Brees couldn't throw a lick in the wind, and Mitchell Trubisky couldn't throw – or Nick Foles started that game, and it was terrible wind. That's how it's going to be.
I'm going to be there. Can't wait.